Hello everyone, welcome back. This is our last lesson of value added tax and hopefully last lecture of our syllabus as well of ACCA basic taxation. We are at value added tax, and as I said in the previous video that we will look at last topic, and it is very, very important topic as far as P6 is concerned in our value added tax. So it's about partial exemptions. So what happens is that so far we have been seeing two things in value-added tax. One was taxable supplies and taxable supplier. Another one was exempt supplies. So there were only two of them. Sometimes what happens is that if you are a businessman, you are doing some taxable supplies as well as exempt supplies too. So in them cases, when you're dealing with both of them at the same time, you are selling taxable supplies and exempt supplies. In that case, it is difficult to determine that how much of the input tax you are going to recoverable, because you are selling taxable supplies and you are selling exempt supplies as well. On the other hand, you are purchasing different stuff for your business. So at the end of the day, when you see your output tax and you see your input tax, now that input tax will not be wholly recoverable because you have been dealing with taxable supplies and exempt supplies. So that input tax will be for both of them, taxable supplies and exempt supplies. So there is a certain way to determine that how much of the total input VAT is actually recoverable from HMRC. So that's what we will see now in our partial exemption, which is our last topic of ACCA basic taxation. I will just share the screen with you, and we will look at the partial exemption. Just bear me 1 second. Right then. That is partial exemption, as you can see. Just before the partial exemption, there's another small topic as well on the next page, about on the page 95 of your lecture notes. If you come to page 95 of your lecture notes, please, it's about imports, exports. So you know at this level that import means that if you're buying something from outside your country. Export means that if you're selling something outside your country. Now we know that exports are very, very good for the country because we are selling something to other countries, so export is very, very good. As far as P6 value added tax is concerned, when we sell something out of our own country, it will either be export or it will be dispatch. Now when we will say it is export and when will we say that it is dispatch, it depends on whether we are selling to other European country or whether we are selling it to non-European country. Now, there is an agreement between the European Union countries, and although you might know about Brexit as well, because now United Kingdom, Great Britain is going to be outside the European Union, because new Prime Minister Theresa May has started the process, as she has invoked the Article 50 of the Lisbon Treaty. On last month, I think it was 29th of March, last month. So which means that we have 2 years. So Britain will eventually be leaving the European Union on 29th of March 2019, because it gives 2 years. Now duration may be extended if the other European Union countries are agreed, but we will assume that United Kingdom will leave on 29th of March 2019. Now it's long ago, so it's long way from our taxation purposes, because our tax year will end on 5th of April 2018 anyway. So after, when the UK leaves the European Union, then there will be different rules for that. But for now, because United Kingdom is still within the European Union, so whenever you are selling something to European Union countries, there is an agreement between European Union countries that they won't charge any value added tax. So the transaction will be disregarded for value added tax purposes. So because assuming, and we know that United Kingdom is still part of European Union, So when you sell anything out of the United Kingdom to European Union country, you won't charge any value added tax. When you buy something out of the, when you buy something from any country within the European Union, still you won't charge, charge any value added tax as far as input tax is concerned. So what I mean to say is because of the agreement between the United Kingdom and the other European Union countries, we won't be charging any value added tax whether we buy or sell within the European Union countries. However, because of the local rules about the value added tax in United Kingdom, we will have to do a few things in order to figure out whether we need to charge value added tax or not. All right. So, for our value added tax purposes, when you sell something to European Union countries, it will be called dispatch. When you sell something outside European Union, it will be called export. When you buy something from the country within the European Union, it will be called acquisition. And when you buy something outside European Union, it will be called imports. So, as I said, exports are very, very good for the countries. So United Kingdom says that whenever you export something, you won't have to pay anything. So it will be zero rated supply. And when I say you sell something outside the country, so when you're selling to European Union countries, it will be disregarded for the value added tax purposes anyway. So when you're selling anything outside European Union, you won't be charging any VAT. It will be zero rated. So that's what it says in the notes as well. It says, first it says exports, then it tells you what the export is. Then it says about imports, dispatches, and acquisitions. So basically, when you do the export, it will be zero rated. When you do dispatches, it will be zero rated as well. When you do imports, what happens is that when you do imports, so you are buying this stuff from the countries outside the United Kingdom. So in this case, it will depend on which kind of supply is it. So if it is zero rated supply, you will be charging tax at the rate of zero rate. And if it is a standard rate supply, you will be charging a tax at the rate of standard rate. As far as dispatches is concerned, as I said, it will be zero rated. However, acquisition, excuse me. Now, acquisition is a thing that when you buy something from the countries within the European Union, what you have to do, although it will be zero rated because of the agreement between the European Union countries, but you have to charge tax, you have to charge depending on what kind of supply is it. So although you will charge in your own accounts, but whatever you are charging, you will have to do opposite to that, so that the net effect is going to be zero. So if you charge, say for example, £100 in our input tax, you will also write same amount in the output tax, so the net figure is going to be zero. So that's what it says in the notes. Term acquisition refers to the goods purchased from countries within the European Union. These are taxed at the standard rate or zero rate, as it would have been taxed in the UK. The same amount of VAT will be written in input and output tax, so the net VAT is going to be neutral. So that's what I said. Because of the agreement between the European Union and the United Kingdom, we can't charge any value tax as far as, even if it is purchase or the sales. But because we need to think about our own value tax as well, we need to think about our own local rules as well, in being in the UK. So what we do is, although we will charge it as per the rates, it depends on the supply. If it is zero rate supply, we will charge it at the rate of zero rate. If it is at the standard rate, we will charge VAT at the standard rate. But because we have charged it, we have to comply with the European Union rules as well. So that's why, in order to comply with the European Union rules, we'll put the same amount in output tax as well. So the eventual effect is going to be zero. In that case, by doing that, we are not only fulfilling UK rules, but you are also fulfilling the European Union regulations as well, right? So that is the way to do it. Then it says about the penalties. Now, the thing is, default surcharge for value added tax purposes. So what happens is that if you have submitted your VAT return late, if you have been late in submitting the VAT return, or if you have paid the VAT late, if you have been late in paying the VAT, then what happens is that UK, HMRC will issue you a notification, which will be known as surcharge liability notice, as it says in the notes. So they will issue you a surcharge liability notice, so which means it depend, they will give you the notice and they will say how long this notice is for. Normally it is for 12 months. So in them 12 months, because they have issued you a warning, it is a warning, they won't, you know, charge you any penalty for that, but it will be just a warning. Now in that warning, it will say that this warning is for 12 months, 10 months or whatever. Normally it is for 12 months. So they will say that please pay your VAT on time or submit your VAT on time, depending on what have you done. Now within that surcharge liability period, you know, surcharge period, if you again either paid the paid the VAT late or you submitted the return late, in either of them within that period, then you will have to pay penalty as well. Now what is that penalty? It depends on whether you are doing it for the first time, second time, third time, or fourth or the later times. So that's what it says in the notes. It says default involving late payment of VAT in the surcharge period. So if it is a first default, the penalty is going to be 2% of the VAT, you know, of the outstanding VAT. So 2% of the outstanding VAT at the due date. If it is a first default, right? So it means that you are doing it for the first time within that, you know, period, be it 12 months or less than that. If it is second default, then it is going to be 5%. If it is third, it is going to be 10%, and it will be 15% if it is the fourth or the more time, right? Now this table is not parallel to the left and right side, so please make sure you do it parallel. So first default is going to be 2%, and the last, the final, you know, maximum is going to be 15%, right? Now penalties for errors in the value of the tax, it is exactly the same way as we have seen earlier in income tax. So no need to do anything with that. Then it says interest on unpaid VAT. So, you know, interest rate, we know that official interest rate is 3%. So we'll have to pay, you know, interest if we have been, you know, if we haven't paid any VAT on time. Let's look at our next topic, which is our, you know, main topic in this lecture, basically. It is about partial exemptions. Yep. And now, as you can see on your page 94, it says partial exemptions and input tax. Now, as I said to you in the start of the lecture, you could either be taxable, you could either be selling taxable supplies, or you could be selling exempt supplies. Sometimes you are selling both of them. You are selling taxable supplies at the same time you're doing exempt supplies as well. So you're doing dealing with the both of them. Now, because you're selling both of them, you are partially exempt in that case. Why partially exempt? Because you are not only selling taxable supplies, but you're also selling exempt supplies. Excuse me. Now in that case, because you're dealing with both of them, whatever your input tax is going to be, because you're doing some purchase as well, whatever your input tax is going to be, that input tax is not wholly recoverable, because some portion is related to taxable supplies and some portion is relevant to exempt supplies as well. So that's why the whole input tax is not going to be recoverable. Now in that case, if you are partially exempt, in that case, how to determine how much of the input tax is recoverable? There is a certain way to do it. Now in question, it will tell you that, you know, Mr. A was doing business, he had taxable supplies of this much, he will have he will have exempt supplies of this much. So we will have been given this information. So you will have taxable supplies, you will have exempt supplies as well. And he will tell you that he will also give you the input VAT. Now, he will give you some input VAT which will be relevant to taxable supplies, which is attributable to taxable supplies, right? Now, they know that this input VAT is attributable to taxable supplies. So we know when it is attributable to taxable supplies, it is wholly recoverable. And the second thing is that they will also give you, you know, value-added tax which is attributable to exempt supplies. Now, as you know that Mr. A is dealing with both supplies, taxable supplies and exempt supplies. So out of the input VAT, you know, the management has decided, management knows that this much of the input VAT is relevant, is attributable to taxable supplies, and this much of the value tax is attributable to exempt supplies. So we know that this much, which is relevant and which is attributable to taxable supplies, we know that it is going to be recoverable because it is attributable to taxable supplies. Second portion, which management has pointed out, it said that this much amount is going to be attributable to exempt supplies. So we know when it is attributable to exempt supplies, it is exempt and it is not going to be recoverable. So we have been given input value-added tax, and management has pointed out that we know, management is saying that they know that this much is attributable to taxable supplies and this much of the total output VAT is attributable to exempt supplies. They know about these two. Then say that this third portion here, we don't know about this portion. We don't know that how much of this portion is attributable to taxable supplies and how much of this portion is attributable to exempt supplies, right? So what is happening here is that this is big chunk of input value tax. Now management has pointed out that one portion of this is attributable to taxable supplies, another portion is attributable to exempt supplies, but this third portion, we are not sure about it, that how much of this third portion is attributable to taxable supplies or the exempt supplies. Now there are three portions, but the one which is attributable to taxable supplies, we know it is recoverable. The one which is attributable to exempt supplies, we know that it is not recoverable, and it is we know it is not recoverable, and it is going to be exempt. Now this third portion, the only problem is about this third portion. Now it is known as unattributable value tax or residual amount, remaining amount, right? This third portion. Now only thing is, only problem is about that, and we have to do a three tests about this. About this portion, we have to to apply three tests, and after applying them three tests, we will determine that how much of this third portion is going to be taxable, recoverable, and how much is not recoverable. All right, now you might be feeling confused about this rule. We will do a question now, then you will understand this concept very well with the help of a past exam paper. But before going to past exam paper, let's read from the notes as well. So it says, where a person makes a mixture of taxable and exempt supplies, they are partially exempt, as I said, and not all of their input tax is recoverable because some of it is attributable to exempt supplies. So for a trader who is partially exempt, input tax must be apportioned between that relating to taxable supplies, which is recoverable, and that relating to exempt supplies, which is exempt. Standard method of attributing input tax is as follows. Now these, it is telling us standard method, different ways, stepwise ways. So first step is calculate how much of the input tax relates to making taxable supplies. As I said, we have to determine how much is relevant to taxable supplies. That will be wholly recoverable. Second one, calculate how much of the input tax relates to making exempt supplies, the second portion. We know that it is going to be exempt. Now this third portion, we're not sure about this one. Calculate how much of any residual, this remaining amount. Now this third portion, we are applying one test. Now calculate how much of this residual amount, remaining amount, input tax is recoverable using the following percentage, following way. Now we are only worried about this third way, third portion, and we have to determine how much of this third portion is recoverable and how much is not recoverable. Now out of this third portion, out of this third portion, some portion is relevant to taxable supplies and some is relevant to exempt supplies. Now how can we do that? We will apply a formula. So we'll take taxable turnover, which will be given to us in the exam, taxable turnover excluding value tax divided by total turnover excluding VAT multiplied by 100. So what we are doing is we are considering that how much of the percentage is of the taxable supplies of the total supplies. So we'll take that this much is total supplies, how much of these total supplies is taxable, how much of these total supplies is exempt. So that's what we are doing. So we'll take that percentage, and it says beneath that that where a residual input tax does not exceed £400,000, then we will round up the percentage which we have just done. So say for example, if it is 24.45, we will round up to 25%. We will do a question in a minute, then you will understand it better. Right, then it says that where the input VAT wholly attributable to exempt supplies plus any residual of VAT attributable to exempt supplies, which means that total of exempt input tax fulfills one of the following tests, then all of the input VAT is going to be recoverable. As I said, we will apply three tests on that, then we will determine that how much, whether it is recoverable or not, then we will determine. All right, so what are these tests? Now you won't understand this test better because these will look confusing. Now we will look at a question. I will just cancel the shared screen. Now please have your lecture notes in front of you. Also, please open your BPP exam kit and come to question number, give me one second. Question number 36 of BPP exam kit, please. Question number 36, which says Spets Limited Group. It was examined in December 2013. And question number 36 of the BPP exam kit, question name is Spets Limited, which was examined in December 2013. So if you have any other exam kit, please make sure you come to this question. Let's read the requirement about that. We're only going to do one portion, which is part A of this question. So it says, calculate the value of the tax partial exemption annual adjustments in Novak Limited for the year ended 30 September 2017 and state when it must be reported to HMRC. You should state with reasons whether or not each of the three de minimis tests is satisfied. Now these three tests which I showed you, which I said do not read it now, the last portion, three tests, these are known as de minimis tests. So we will apply these three de minimis tests. Now if we are successful in applying any of the test, then we will recover whole of the input tax. Right, now let's read the question as well. It is relevant to Novak Limited. Let's go to Novak Limited now. Here it is, as you can see on your screen, Novak Limited. Now figures for the tax year, figures for the year ended 30 September 2017. Now it has given us the figures. The first one is taxable supplies excluding VAT. So we have been given the taxable supplies. We have been given the exempt supplies as well. After that, it says input tax. Now input tax attributable to taxable supplies is also given. Now, input tax attributable to exempt supplies is also given. Now, attributable to taxable supplies, we know that it is going to be wholly recoverable. Please look at your notes. Step 1. It says, calculate how much of the input tax relates to making taxable supplies. This is deductible in full. In your notes, please. Now, this amount, which is wholly attributable to taxable supplies, this is going to be wholly recoverable. Now look at your notes, step number 2. I'm talking about step number 2, not test number 2. Step number 2, please. It says, calculate how much of the input tax relates to making exempt supplies. This is exempt input VAT. Now look at your question. In the question, it says, attributable to exempt supplies, £4,900. Now we know that this is attributable to exempt supplies. It is not recoverable. Right then, look at the third step. It says calculate how much of the any residual amount, remaining amount, unattributable amount, in other words, is recoverable using the following percentage. Now let's look at in the question if there is any unattributable. Yes, it is given in the question. If you see, it is 16,100. 16,100 in the question. Right, now this 16,100 is unattributable. We know that we are not sure about it, that how much is recoverable and how much is not. So we have to apply this formula which is given to us in step number 3. So what we do is we take taxable supplies. How much is taxable supplies in the question? 1190,000, right? Then divided by total turnover. So taxable turnover, not taxable supplies, taxable turnover, which is given to us in the question 1190. Taxable supply basically is exactly the same thing, sorry. So taxable supplies 1190, which is given to us in the question, divided by total supplies, total turnover. Now total turnover means taxable turnover plus exempt turnover, so it is going to be total turnover, right? So multiplied by 100, so we will take this percentage, and we know that residual input VAT is less than 400,000 pounds, so we'll round up this percentage. Now we'll just cancel the shared screen and we'll start doing the question on the board. Please keep your exam kit in front of you. Right then, give me 1 second. Right. So, what does it say? Taxable supplies are 1190 and exempt supplies are 430. So both of them are given to us in the question, and we can do the total of that. Right then. Now it says input tax attributable to taxable supplies. We know that it is wholly recoverable. So input tax input VAT attributable to taxable supplies and how much it is 12,200. So 12,200, we know that it is going to be wholly recoverable. Step 1 of your notes, please. Then it says attributable input tax attributable to exempt supplies. We know it is not recoverable. Step 2 of your notes. Then in step 3, it says look at your unattributable, the remainder of the input VAT. Now, remainder of the input VAT, which is 16,100, we are not sure about it, that how much of this is recoverable and how much of it is not recoverable. So we will have to apply one formula. We will have to see how much of the taxable supplies is as a percentage of total supplies, right? So in order to do that, what we do is we'll take taxable supplies, which is 1190, divided by total supplies, which is going to be 1190 plus 430. I'm ignoring the thousand, so the percentage is going to be exactly the same, so don't worry about it. All right, so bear me 1 second. Just let me pick my calculator. So 1190 plus 430, 1620. So it is going to be 1620. It is going to be 1620. So 1190 divided by 1620. Please make sure you do it on the calculators. So 1190 divided by 1620. Is going to be 73.45. Now it is 73.45. Now it says in the notes when the remainder of the input VAT is less than 400,000 pounds, we will round up this percentage. So it is 73.45. We will do it 74%. So that is going to be 74%, right? So that is, we know that it is 74%. So what we now need to do is, we'll have to, let's go back to the question. What we need to do now is see how much is unattributable. Now, 74% of the unattributable is attributable to taxable supplies. 74%, because we know that 74% is, what is this percentage? Now, 74% of the total supplies is taxable supplies. That's what we did in this formula. 74% of the total supplies is taxable supplies. So we will apply this 74% to unattributable. So unattributable portion, unattributable portion of taxable supplies. So it is going to be 74% of how much? 16,100. So that is going to be recoverable as well. So how much it is? Let me do it on this calculator because I can't hold two things at the same time. 16,100 into 74%. 16,100 into 74% is going to be 11,914. So 11,914. All right. So that is an unattributable portion of taxable supplies. So we know that 74% of this unattributable is attributable to taxable supplies, basically. So that's why it is, it is recoverable. Right. Now going back to the question and keeping in your notes front of you, please make sure you keep your notes in front of you. So how much is the remainder of the unattributable? So 16,600. So you just do here 16,100 less 11,914. So the remaining one is how much? We'll have to choose the calculator again. So 16,100 less 11,914. Remaining one is 4,186. Now this is relevant to exempt supplies. All right, this is relevant to exempt supplies. Now we know that it is relevant to exempt supplies. All right, give me 1 second. My computer is playing up. Right, so we know that it is relevant to exempt supplies. It is relevant to exempt supplies of the unattributable portion, and another figure is given to us in the question, which is which was given to us in the question, which says it is attributable to exempt supplies straight away. That portion, if you see in the question, £4,900, input tax attributable to exempt supplies. Now £4,900 is attributable to exempt supplies straight away. However, we calculated this 4186 as well on top of that 4900. This is also relevant to exempt supplies with the help of this formula 7400. 7400 is relevant to taxable supplies. Remaining percentage is relevant to exempt supplies. Great. Now this one is relevant to exempt supplies, and 4900 is relevant to exempt supplies as well. Now both of these exempt both of these which is relevant to exempt supplies may be recoverable. It could be recoverable if any of the three de minimis test applies. All right, so let's look at the three de minimis tests from your notes, please. And give me 1 second. Right, on page 94 of your 93 of your notes, I think. Page 95 of your notes, sorry. Page 95 of your notes. So it says test number one. Now we will apply three tests which are known as de minimis tests. Now if we are successful in applying them, any of the tests apply successfully, then this amount plus 4900, which is given to us in the question, plus 4900, then whole amount, this as well, then this whole amount is going to be recoverable as well, subject to these conditions, subject to these tests being satisfied. So what are these tests? Just before the test, it says, read this please. Just before the tests, it says where the input VAT wholly attributable to exempt supplies. Now input tax wholly attributable to exempt supplies. How much is it in our question? Input tax wholly attributable to exempt supplies. In our question, it is 4,900. Wholly attributable to exempt supplies. We know it was given to us in the question. Right, so input tax attributable, wholly attributable to exempt supplies plus residual VAT attributable to exempt supplies. Now residual VAT attributable to exempt supplies in our question it is 4186. We took it out of the residual portion, right? So then in the brackets it says IE, that is the total of exempt input VAT. Now these two is total of input VAT. Fulfills one of the following tests. If it fulfills one of the following tests, then all input VAT is recoverable, then whole of the input VAT and this too as well, although this is recoverable, we know that, but this will also be recoverable if any of these de minimis test applies. So what are these tests? It says in the tests that first test, total input VAT is 625 or less a month on average. So let's look at this one. 625 total input VAT. So how much is going to be total input VAT? Let's look at in the question. So in the question it says input VAT. So total is going to be 12,200. Just do it here. We can do it. I'll just do it here. So total is going to be 12,200 plus 4,900 plus 16,100. So how much is going to be 16, 18, 28, 32, 33, 200. Please make sure you redo it. I'm just doing it without the calculator. Please make sure you redo it. Alright, so total input VAT is going to be 33,200. So what does the first test says? First test says that total input VAT is 625 or less a month and on average. Now this 33,200 is for 1 year. We need to see that if per month is 625 a month on average or less than that. Let me just check this figure as well, 12,200. Give me 1 second. Plus 4,900 plus 16,100. 33,200, yeah. So let's see, 33,200 divided by 12, it is far more than 625. It is 2766. 2766. It is far more than that. Right. So when we know that it is, you know, more than 625, so we know that this test won't apply. We don't need to see if, you know, the second portion of this first test. So it was first portion of the first test. The second portion, it says within the first test, and value of exempt supplies is 50% or less of total supplies. We don't need to go to that because we know that this test won't apply. So we don't need to go further. However, we don't need to go further, but we will still see that if it it is successful or not. If it applies or not. So a value and value of exempt supplies is 50% or less of total supplies. So how much is value of exempt supplies? Value of exempt supplies is, how much is it? 430. So value of exempt supplies is 430 and out of total and total of 1620, we know it is less than 50%. So although this test, this portion of the test, it is successful, but this portion it is not fulfilling. So 33,200 divided by 12, it is more than 625 a month on average. So we know that first test won't apply. Now look at the second test, please. Second test say that total input VAT, so total input VAT, how much is total input VAT? We'll have to look at the question again. So total input VAT. So taxable input VAT to taxable is 12,200. As total input VAT, we have already calculated here as well. So total input VAT is 33,200. We have already calculated. So total input VAT, so what does the test say? Total input VAT less input VAT directly attributable to taxable supplies. So total input VAT less directly attributable to taxable supplies. How much it is? 12,200. Deduct this one out of this. So total input VAT less directly attributable to taxable supplies is 625 or less than on average a month. So let's see, divided by 12. So what we need to do is 33,200 less 12,200. Divided by 12, so it is 1750. We know, you know, this test won't apply as well because it is more than 625. We know it is more than 625. Right, so we know when it is more than 625, we know that this test won't apply as well. So, you know, it is more than 625. Now, second portion of this test says, and value of exempt supplies is 50% or less than of total supplies. We know that we have already done that. So value of exempt supplies, 630 divided by 1620, it is more than, you know, it is less than 50%. We already know it. So although that this portion of the test is fulfilled successfully, but this is not, so we know that this test also won't apply. So we will have to go to test three now. Now in the test three, in your notes please, it says input VAT wholly attributable to exempt supplies. Input VAT wholly attributable to exempt supplies. How much is it? 4900 in our case. Input VAT wholly attributable to taxable supplies. Input VAT wholly attributable to exempt supplies. Plus residual VAT attributable to exempt supplies. Residual VAT attributable to exempt supplies is how much? Here it is, 4186. Right, so it means that total of exempt input VAT, so how much is it? Total of this is going to be 9086, I think, if I'm not wrong. And it says that it must be less than 625 a month on average. So let's see. 4186 plus 4900. Yep, 9086 divided by 12. It is 757. So it is also more than 625 a month on average. It is also more than that. So we know that this test won't apply as well. All right. So we know that this test won't apply as well. So what I mean to say is, in our specific question, neither test one nor test two, and also the test three does not apply as well. So we know that this exempt portion, of both of these exempt portion, is not recoverable. So only these portions are recoverable, which we have already seen. Right. So let's come back to the question again. So attributable to taxable supplies, we've already calculated. Attributable to exempt supplies, it is not recoverable. Unattributable, 16,100 multiplied by 74%, this percentage we took out of this one. So we know that this is recoverable as well, which is 11,914. So let's see how much is total of this. So 24114, I think. That is 24114, and recovered on the four quarterly returns prior to annual adjustments. Now in the question it told us that we have already recovered from HMRC 23,200. So we've already recovered 23,200, and so we need to make annual adjustments. So what does annual adjustment means? That we will see at end of each VAT period that how much have we recovered and how much we actually should have recovered. So we should have recovered 24,114, whereas we actually recovered 23,200, which is given to us in the question, 23,200. So this one is the amount which we have recovered. So already recovered. Already recovered and we should have recovered. Should have recovered 24,114, already recovered 23,200. So whatever the remaining amount is, this is still recoverable from HMRC. Still recoverable from HMRC, and this is going to be our annual adjustment as well. Annual adjustment. Whatever the figure is, please make sure you deduct this one out of this one. So whatever this figure is, and this is going to be our, we will ask HMRC that please pay us this amount, because we should have recovered 24,114, whereas we actually recovered 23,300. So this is the amount that we still need to recover. So that's why please pay us this amount because we have under-recovered. And we will make annual adjustment as well. So basically, annual adjustment, the way to do the annual adjustment is the way we did it here. So we first calculate that how much we should have recovered. Then we will see how much we have already recovered. The remaining amount is going to be our annual adjustment, right? So please make sure you redo this question. And also a last part of this question, if you look at the last part, which is part D, I think, give me 1 second. A part C of this question, which is worth 5 marks. This is also a basic question relevant to employment benefits and also overseas aspects of employment. You remember that we did one small portion in capital gains tax, I think. We did small portion where we said that overseas aspects. So when an employee goes overseas, then you know what will be the consequences, how much they should pay, you know, the flight, you know, when they go out, when they go overseas, employer will be paying for the flight. So what would happen about that? And their way back, that flight as well, outward flight. And if their family needs to visit the husband or the wife, that flight as well. So these things we have already seen in our notes. So please make sure you redo them as well. Sorry, slip of tongue. Bear me 1 second. I'm just looking that if I need to tell you anything else as well. So all of the questions which I have been telling you, please make sure you redo them. And if you come to page 45 of your lecture notes, if you come to page 45 of your lecture notes, page 45, yep, page 45. Travel expenses borne by employer for employee's duty abroad and travel expenses incurred by employee for duties abroad. Now these two, first two headings of this page number 45 of your lecture notes, please read this page and do this question, C portion of this question, which we have just done. Its name is Spats, I think. And question number 38, let me just check again. Question number 36, sorry. Question 36, part C. So read page 45 of your lecture notes, then come to question number 36, part C, and also redo this portion as well, because it is very, very important. A de minimis test is very, very important as far as exam is concerned, and it is easy as well. Do not confuse these things. Just learn the rules, learn these three de minimis tests which are given to us in the notes, and you will be easy to, you know, you will easily be able to do it. It's not difficult, but the only thing is that you must know the rules, you must know these three tests and the way to do it, then it is very, very easy to do. There is no difficulty at all. All right, so that's it for our this video, and that's it for our all the lectures. And now there will be one video left in this our course, so I'll be sharing some exam tips, some important questions out of the BBP kit, and I'll be telling you a little bit of technical stuff as well as far as actual exam is concerned. So just wait for one video, and which will be following in, you know, next day or no, couple of days. I don't know when they upload this video, but you know, there's one video still left out of this syllabus, so I will tell you that, you know, important exam tips and all that. All right, so good luck for your exam. So keep practicing all the questions which I have noted down and which I have done on the board and I have gone through with you during our lectures, and if I have given you any homework in some cases. So please make sure you redo all of these questions, and I will see you in the next video, and which will be our concluding video of the P6 Finance Act 2016. Thank you very much. Have a nice day and good luck.